Hey guys, welcome to the video. And in this, basically, we'll basically try to mimic our database. So we'll not be using a real database, but we'll be using a list. We'll create an API to get the data from the list, add data from the list, and delete the data from the list if it exists, right? So without wasting much of time, let's get started. We learned about the get and post, right? Let us create a list. So right here, or basically, let me create a constructor here, and I'm gonna create a list called self.data, right? That's my data structure, or think this as it's coming the data from the data structure, right? So by default there is one name called Saumil, right? So let us pass this data structure now, and we'll create APIs to add data, remove data, and stuff like that. Beautiful, right? Let us test our get request so that we can get the data, hopefully. We'll learn about serializers and all, everything in the later coming videos. So Python 3 manage.py, M-A-N-A-G-E, manage.py, run server. Okay, sorry for that. I think I entered the command incorrectly. Python 3 manage.py, run server. And now we should get this static data, right? That is already there. So performing some checks. Let's expand this and refresh it. Sure enough, it should work. Yeah, you see, we have our data, right? Now, let us create a get, put, and delete request, right? A data structure which will add data, delete data, right? So now remember, this is a data. This is basically a dictionary. So we're gonna extract the name by saying data dot get name comma, if the name is not found, return none. Okay, once we get the name, so we'll say self dot data dot append, right? That name, right? And in the response, we should say the name response 200, data is equal to name. We should say this as data, and let's call message or let's say right. We are mimicking it right now. Okay, so now technically we have our get and put, which will add data to the database, or in short our list data structure. Let's run this and see whether it works correctly. Right, Python 3. Okay, we have a small issue, and the issue is basically we forgot the comma. Let's fix that. Rerun the server. Perfect, very good. Now let us go to our API. Let me refresh it. And we should see one member right now here, right? So remember, we'll say name. There is no validation right now, okay? So we are just learning it, right? So, right? So, that's my dad's name, Nitin. Right? Let's try to put it a capital. Okay, let's try to add this and see what do we get. I press the post button and you can see 200 response data Nitin message item was added to the database. Let us try to get it. Okay, now the question is why it did not get it. So what happened is basically when we click on the get request, it basically restarts the server. So this data, Saumil, when we added Nitin in that, it was already there. But when we clicked the get, it restarted and our data was lost. So that's why you can see we need a database, right? To make sure that we do not lose information. So let me do the get first of all. Gonna click on get. So here you can see I showed you why we need a database, right? So in the upcoming videos, we'll learn about the database as well. I could have done is basically I could have created this data as a global variable and try it, right? This is just for learning purpose. Remember, we are just learning it right now. But I'm not sure if we can access this class object outside. So I have to call global data. So I'm just creating a global variable now, right? So I'm not sure if this is gonna work. It might not work, okay? So data.append name, we add the name, right? And sure enough, the response. Let's restart the server and try it again and see whether we get Sawmill here. This is just to show you that we are mimicking it, right? Our ultimate goal would be we'll convert this into a database, right? Which we are gonna learn in the upcoming videos, okay? So do not worry about that. So has started, right? Let's refresh it now. We should see some front end or UI. Here you can see Sawmill, it's back, right? Let's try to add now. And make sure that your name that you're saying is capital, right? So here also it has to be capital. Okay, so I just added a name. Wanna click on the post button right here. Let's see, bang, ooh, what happened? Dict object has no attribute append. Yep, that's right. So we go to the post here and it says there is no attribute called as name. This name basically append, right? So where it did give me an error. So says dictionary object has no attribute append. So let's go and see, find out the error. It says line 23. Oh, right here. So here you can see this is where the error is. So why it was not able to add it? So the question answer is simple. The name of the variable is same, right? So there is a data collision. So let's change this as my data, right? So it's gonna get my data and we have it in the name, right? Then we want to append the data. So it's gonna be data.append name, right? And here it's gonna be name as well. Let's try to run this again and see if this time it works or not. All right, let's go to the browser, localhost. Hit the refresh button right here. Should open up. We have our static member Sawmill, right? Let's try to insert a new element. Right. Let's try to post it. Again, it blows up. Now it says list object has no attribute my data. Let's see where did we go wrong. So list attribute. Oops, what am I doing? So I made a very simple typo issues. So I'm getting the data, right? Then it should be my data. Sorry, I'm really very, very sorry for the mistake. So now my data.get name, right? It's in the name. Then we append the name in that global data variable, and sure enough, now it should work. So here you can see debugging is also one of the skills that you need to have while creating APIs or creating any kind of projects. So when you have any errors, don't be afraid, read the errors and you will get it. So now let's try for the third time whether this works. Right. Hopefully now it should work. I'm gonna click on the post button. Yes, it got added. Now let's click on the get button. And you can see we have both the names inside the database. Now let's add third person. So remember, as soon as the program restart, all the data is gone because that's not in the database. Okay. So that's my mother name, Suhas, right? I'm gonna click on the post button right here and was added, right? Let me do a get request. Now there are three persons in the database, right? Cool. Let us try to implement a put and a delete request also. So I have my post request. Let us try to define. Let me close this session here. So I'm gonna say I wanna do delete. So basically there is nothing called as delete. It's either put request. All right, so let's do a put request. So let's say put. Similarly, you can do is basically call the variable. Call the response. I'm not gonna code it, just wanna show you that even this will work. So similarly, you can add put, get, post, delete, whatever you want, right? So just showing you essentially that even this will be working. Of course, then you need to add the business logic. So here you can see that is put request, which will update the value. So we can pass in the value like name. It will check whether that name is there and you can update that value, right? Like we can pass in an index also, like whatever index we wanna change the name. So that's, you pretty much got the logic, right? So we did get, post and put, right? So thank you for watching. In the next video, we'll learn about database migration, right? We'll create our database, do migrations and learn how to access that from the admin portal, right? So see you guys in the next video.